If you would take a handful of pasta, just regular spaghetti noodles, and you threw it on the ground, however it landed, that would be the best explanation I could give you of what our Gulf Coast looks like in terms of pipelines. And it's anywhere from a 4-inch pipe to a 30-something inch pipe.
Hi, I'm Severin Cullis Suzuki. You're watching Samoguan, Water Stories. The oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico was so vast, it required thousands of volunteers and all of the available and capable vessels along the coastlines of three states. Louisiana and Mississippi were in the direct line of the crew that washed ashore, and many of the fishermen and boat charter operators were hired by the BP company in a program called the Vessel of Opportunity. They were trained by consulting companies hired by BP to contain the spill. The fishermen had been immediately halted from fishing, so the job was a welcome economic boost. And for the tour operators, their phones had stopped ringing, so working for BP was a reprieve as well. Both groups felt the difficulties of sitting on a double-edged sword. Today we will meet a tour operator who started out as a curious young boy exploring the Louisiana swamps with friends. The bayou became the school for Derek Billiott and a place that would become the livelihood for the Houma native guy from Belle Chasse, a self-described swamp man.
My grandfather was a trapper by trade, hunter and trapper. That's how he made his living. And most of my family and all of the generations, that's how they did it. And today, it's definitely a different world, but at that time, everybody made their living out here in the swamp, in the marshes, hunting, fishing, catching everything from shrimp, crabs, the nutria, you name it, to me, to make their money, the gator.